Good afternoon, RHS. I'm Daisy.
And I'm Marissa, and this is your Daily Dose for Wednesday, October 2nd, 2024.
Today is Fall Count Day. This is an important day for students to be in attendance, as it is how funding is determined for our school.
The next Science Club meeting is tomorrow, October 3rd, right after school in the planetarium. This group is a fun group that does things like the annual field trip for the River Rouge cleanup and Night of the Star for little kids to learn and check out the planetarium. Mrs. Weller would love to see some new faces at the next meeting, so come by and check it out. Our club is canceled Thursday this week. Instead, it's on Friday.
Have you noticed the new pavilion in the courtyard? Lola, Seth, and Shane went around asking students and staff about it.
Good afternoon, RHS. Recently, there was a grant passed to build a pavilion where students can go outside and eat lunch. It is expected to open this October. Now we're going to talk to Ms. Ferris, who helps supervise the grant.
Who came up with the idea?
Once I heard about the grant, I had a few ideas, and one of them was to create a pavilion space in this courtyard for the whole school to use.
When will it be open?
And they're hoping maybe in October. If the weather gets too cold by then, hopefully next spring.
Who's going to be allowed to come out here?
Teachers can sign up to take their classes out during any class period, and then at lunch, as far as I know, any student during their lunch can come out here.
Now to you, Lola.
Okay, who will be supervising the outside?
So right now it will be school staff, probably one of the administrators, but it could also be part of our lunch crew.
Why did you guys decide that this was a good idea?
So it's a beautiful space. We spend so much time indoors, so we just thought, why can't we use this outdoor space, get outside? We have some great weather going on here in Michigan, so we just want to capitalize on it.
Who will all be allowed to go outside?
So during the school day and during lunchtime, if we can open it on that day that we have enough, we will be opening it during lunch.
When will it be open?
It's very staff contingent for lunchtime right now. And we also plan on having that space available to the students at our homecoming dance.
And now what students think. Have you heard of the new lunch extension that's coming this October?
Yeah, I heard it's outside and it's the pavilion.
Will you be going outside?
Oh, absolutely. It looks amazing.
Do you have any concerns for this?
Not at all. Just basically how many people can fit out there, because I know a lot of people are going to want to use it.
Looks like the pavilion is going to be a great extension to RHS. What do you guys think?
Next week is Bright Lights in Big Cities, homecoming week featuring Spirit Week at RHS. Get ready to show your bear pride. Monday is pajama day. Tuesday is twin day. Wednesday is tacky tourist day. Thursday is class color day. The freshmen are blue and green. Sophomores are orange and purple. Juniors are pink and yellow, and seniors are black and white. Friday is blue and gold day. Get your outfits ready, Bears.
Also part of Spirit Week will be the annual junior versus senior Powder Puff game on Tuesday, October 8th at 6 p.m. There will be a $5 entry for everyone, cash only. This is a fundraiser and not a part of the sports pass system. There will be a concession stand to purchase pizza, drinks, as well as and other snacks as well. Come out and watch the junior girls face off against the senior girls on the football field while the junior and senior guys cheer them on in front of the sidelines.
Friday will be a half day featuring the pep rally with class games. See a class officer to sign up to be part of the fun. Also on Friday will be the homecoming parade at 6 p.m. and the football game at 7 p.m. During the halftime, the homecoming king and queen will be crowned.
Then, on Saturday, the dance will be held in the cafetorium from 7 to 10 p.m. The deadline to purchase tickets is Friday, October 11th at noon. Guest passes are available in the front office. Only 11th and 12th graders are allowed to take an outside guest. Tickets are $30 and are available through GoFan.
Now here's Kane with sports.
Thanks, Marissa. Varsity boys soccer beat Taylor 8-2 on Monday, key players being Caden Harris, who scored 4 goals, and Aiden Jeffries, who scored twice. Next up for the soccer team is a game tonight at Gabriel Richard, and then tomorrow is their charity match to help childhood cancer at home against Airport. The JV is at 5:30 and varsity is at 7 p.m. All funds raised will be donated to a local childhood cancer charity. Come out and show your support for this great cause and our soccer team. Boys tennis had a tournament tonight at Etzel Ford, where the team placed third with 4 singles coming from Lucas Cup, 3 from Ryder Chavez, and 1 from Brooks Blackledge. JV's girls golf was going to play Monday against Southgate, but unfortunately the match was canceled and will not be rescheduled. Cross country had a league jamboree yesterday as well. The girls were missing a couple key runners due to injury, and running in the rain wasn't helping either, but they came fourth with Mercedes D finishing 13th overall. The boys had great weather and placed third. Noah Mori was the top finisher at fourth overall. Swim also had a meet at Garden City where they won 108-34. El Malia and Lydia were some key swimmers during the matchup. Tomorrow, volleyball plays at home against Lincoln Park. Freshmen and JV start at 5:30 and varsity at 7 p.m. Come show your support. Football plays at Allen Park this week. JV teams are at AP on Thursday, and the varsity is at home Friday at 7 p.m. Next week, tennis and soccer start playoffs, with soccer having pre-districts on Wednesday and tennis competing at Allen Park in the regional match. Now back to the anchors.
Attention all students. Are you interested in the WAC exchange this year? WAC involves traveling to stay with a host student where you will explore the city and its landmarks. You will also go to the host student's school for a day. Eventually, the students will come to Wyandotte and you'll show them all around our town and school. This year, we'll be exchanging with a school in Kinston, North Carolina. See Mrs. Souls for more information.
Looking for a fun account to follow on TikTok? The Trading Post has a new TikTok account where Steven and Ryan will be tasting and reviewing products. Follow at Taste of the Post on TikTok for updates and entertainment.
Homework Den is up and running for any students who may need some extra help. Come to LMC Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday from 3 to 4. Teachers from all subject areas will be there to help you out.
Any senior interested in college visits? This week will include MSU today, U of M Dearborn on Thursday, and Grand Valley on Friday. Next week's visits will include Henry Ford College and Saginaw Valley State University. See Mrs. Neal in the counseling office for a pass to any of these visits.
Also, if you signed up for EMU or Schoolcraft visit, they have been rescheduled for October 28th. EMU is second hour and Schoolcraft is seventh hour.
Make sure to subscribe to us on YouTube at RHS Media and follow us on TikTok and Instagram at Wyandotte Television.
That's it all for today, RHS. Have a great day.